I'll be there if you also don't have time. I want to take you through a short story about the death of my wife. It was in April 2017 when we made an appointment with the doctor in Nairobi, wanting to have a kid. And because of the age, the doctor advised us to go for a test on her biology. It's at that point it was at that point that another appointment in Miami. So when we went to the hospital, we straight away sent us to the lab, sent us to the lab, and she did the tests for which they asked us to go back on Wednesday. So on Wednesday, when we went back, the doctor advised us that her viability was not okay to have a kid at that stage. But she needed to put her some treatment to boost her viability, something like that. So when he was preparing to write the treatment, that's when my wife said that, doctor, can I go through this treatment where I'm suspected of having cancer on the breast? Professor said no. You cannot undergo the treatment when there is suspicion of cancer. Because if it is true, if it becomes true, then that will be a disaster. So he said, I have to get taken back to the lab to rule out that suspicion. Unfortunately, at that time, my wife was supposed to fly back on the following day. That was on a Thursday. So she told us that I'm flying away back to Boston tomorrow. So the doctor said, it's fine. I'm going to write for you the lab request. And he wrote 6 different items and step on his business card. He said, go to Boston and send me his results. Indeed, after 1 week, I got a call from the doctor. Professor Kutu is in Nairobi. So he called me and told me that no, Stanislas proves, I confirm that Bruce has passed. But it is still at an initial stage, almost at a zero stage. But you shouldn't worry about this. I am going to, I also need to go back to the hospital where she's been going to and do surgery. After you do the surgery, then you can come back and proceed with our problem. So I called those and asked her, I want to tell her what the doctor told me. Then she told me that no, I want to speak to the doctor. I think when she got the results, called her first, then he called me. So 2 months later, I went to Boston and I initiated that we go to the hospital. Went to the hospital and we met the doctor who was always attached to the growth in that hospital in Boston. She's a white lady. And when we entered into her office, she asked me who I was. And I told her that that's my husband. And she told me, I hope people have come for us to go home on Saturday. I told her, yes, we want to do Saturday. So she took a clue on how the surgery is supposed to be done. She gave us two options. The first option was to do
she was opting to ask the doctor to change the treatment.
decided to change the treatment into tablets. Now, those tablets caused an effect on her. It started making her weak. It started changing her color of the skin. A few of you who were close to my wife recently when she came could have seen it. And I told her that why don't you go back to the doctor and change it? I will go back to the previous medication. And indeed she went and that medication was changed and her skin went back to normal. But I went to Boston in October. So what happened? The life of my wife was no longer that one that used to be. Sometimes she would weep, she would get weak, sometimes she would have no appetite. But one night, she felt very, very high temperature and a headache, of which she made her very uncomfortable. She couldn't sleep. She even started having itches. So she googled certain chemical cream for the itches. And she gave me the address for a somewhere in Malibu. There is a which is very far away from our house. I went there, I got the cream, she applied her skin. She was still restless. Then the following morning, I said, okay, let's go to hospital. She told me, no, we are planning to go to a certain company called Kola. So she said, no, you go to Kola, let me go to hospital. So when she went to hospital, she called me around Friday in the evening that the doctor has decided to retain her. So I tried to convince him that, oh, mom, I should take it from. I went to the hospital that evening and I told her that I tried to call Jesse to come with me, but Jesse was not able to make his call. He said, no, don't tell Jesse anything, I'll be okay. So I think the first day, the second day, the third day is when I went with Jesse. She was in treatment and the treatment was being when I asked her how she was, how she slept those nights. She felt better. And it distracted us from the last one week. I stayed there for another 1 week and her condition has slightly improved. As you see, I have a lot of obligations here. I said I came back with her. So, one day she told me she wasn't feeling well because she had resumed work and they had tied her with a lot of work. And she suspected that that's maybe what's making her work and weaker. And I told her, is there anything that you can do about that? Then she told me, I think I just need to leave this job and do something else. I told her that, okay, now you have to plan before you leave that job. You have to plan for what is and do a proper study whether that is going to be something viable. So, later on, I got a call from Sister's husband, Dr. Musu, that yesterday we took your wife to hospital and she's not well. She's very sick. And you have to find time and come. And she's supposed to do surgery. I think the first day, the second day, they were trying to look for space in the theater. days and she didn't settle. That story all RCC Yakuga as well. What happened? I don't need to repeat that. Okay. I want to say something very brief about my life in Kofi. I knew Kofi back way back in Kumi when she was working for Nutrition Project. That's how I came to know her. And she was a client in the guest house I go in Kumi. And we had nothing yet, like a relationship. Until when there was room in me that I needed to find myself a wife. And a friend told me that this was coming in 2 weeks in Uganda. As somebody who I knew very well, when I started talking and we agreed to get married. I have loved my wife dearly from the time we got married. And she has loved me dearly. She changed my life. She changed my best friend. She brought me very close to church. From the time we got together, there is one Sunday that we have lived together and I don't go to church. Maybe those days when I'm home, she said, when I'm not here, it's when I can miss church. But when I'm with her, we never used to miss church. And a lot. And she also used to love like the way I have loved her. So, I want to thank the team from the US first, and Cecilia, and Doctor. You really wished us well. I remember the first time when I came to Boston, I was not used to the American food. You received me, you used to cook food and bring to the hotel where I used to stay. You have already shown that consistency. The life of my wife. I really appreciate so much. I would also like to thank the TESO community in Boston. After they had died, their chairperson called me and asked me for permission to solicit money to support the process of processing profession from the US. That community worked very hard and the money was left us up to about $4,700. Cecilia, I want you to thank those people when we get here. When I get back there, I want to make sure that I talk to them physically. Those people did something that I did not expect. And after they collected the money, I told the chairman called me and I told him that no, you don't need to send that money back here. You take that money to the doctor and it will help us to pay for the funeral home. So it reduced our burden. I said 10,000 and then they took up the balance. So I would also like to thank the team here in Uganda. The moment they heard that I have lost my wife, most especially in the beginning, my brothers. My brothers ran, got hold of me, and kept me shoulder by shoulder. We walked a journey, and I felt strength because I really felt that I felt I My brother here, Davis, has been with me like this. I remember those who were there when I was marrying those, when I was getting married to those, we stood the same way, and he has not been standing with me. This is something very bad. Joseph, are you up? I think we have. My family supported me. I think from the very first time when I started coming to Kampala, I've been with Kampala. And when they heard about those truths, they have supported us in all the way.